know the life of Paul. He had been through many trials. He'd been shipwrecked. He'd been persecuted. He'd been beaten. He'd been thrown in prison. And this is what he wrote in Romans 8. He says, "What can separate us from the love of Christ?" That was his question. What can separate us from the love of Christ? And then he goes on to say, difficulties, trials, persecutions, challenges. None of this can separate us from Christ's love. What he was saying, what I'm going through right now, that doesn't mean God doesn't love me. There is no separation in God's love. But can I ask you this question? Can we separate ourselves from thinking God loves us from the way we think? Can we make that separation in our own mind when it's not true? And when we separate ourselves in our own thinking, how do we get to the goodness of God? How do we believe in the cross? How do we live that stable and secure life? See, that's why the enemy wants you to reflect your worthlessness on God. If he can make you think you're not worthy, he'll make you think God thinks you're not worthy. And can I tell you, you got to point yourself back to the cross, because you don't deserve it. No, you don't deserve it. I don't deserve it. But Jesus thinks we do. And he paid it all for us. He paid it all for us.